POCO just unveiled three devices that cover the budget, the mid-range, and the upper mid-range spectrum of smartphones for 2024. And actually, it's the beginning of 2024. So without further ado, let's go ahead and talk about the POCO X6 Pro. This is obviously the upper mid-range with the Dimensity 8300. Of course, right next to that is, of course, the POCO X6 5G. And this one's going to be featuring the Snapdragon 7S Gen 2, an upgraded version from the one we've seen before. And the last one is the M6 Pro, powered by the Helio G99 Ultra, providing us an upper budget entry device from POCO. This is TK, and let's go ahead and talk and figure out which one is the right one for you. Like and subscribe, and make sure you hit that bell icon so that you're always notified to whenever we have new videos on the channel. In front of us, we have the brand new devices from POCO. So first and foremost, we'll look in here is the X6 Pro that's present here on the left side. It's a 5G device. We'll notice that the overall design that we're getting here transitions from one style to the other. The X6 does carry very similar aesthetics as far as the having the triple camera stack on the back, but the design changes a little bit and a little bit more reflective. And it is still carrying the 5G logo, so that will be the X6 here, positioned in the center. And last but not least is the M6, the M as in Mary 6 Pro. This is going to be the entry or the upper entry-level smartphone from the bunch that we're looking at here. Surprisingly, when we're looking at them overall as far as devices, there's a lot of similarities, and we're going to talk about that. First and foremost, all three of them are powered, or basically going to be charged up, let's let this focus, with a 67-watt charger that's included in the box. So each one of them has one of these two, a USB A to C, that's going to be one connecting here to charge up our device, and of course, charging the batteries that we have built in. We have a 5,000 milliampere battery here, a 5,100 milliampere in the X6, and then of course, a 5,000 in the M6 Pro. The reason the changes in here, I'm not sure, but there's a few other things that they also share, and that is the primary sensor on the back. That's going to be the main sensor in there. It's going to be a 64 megapixel camera with OIS on all three camera systems, an 8 megapixel ultra wide, and a 2 megapixel technically depth slash macro camera that gives us the ability of taking some of those close-up shots. No wireless charging on any of these devices, different color options availability, as well as the fact that they're all going to be using the same technology to charge, and that's going to be that 67 watt charger included in the box. And before we forget, of course, each one of them comes with a case included in there. So other than the case and, of course, the SIM ejector tool, we're pretty much going to be there. And last but not least, the M6 Pro is not a 5G device. This is a 4G LTE device, depending on the market that you pick it up. But other than that, you're pretty much looking at a very similar experience. We have a volume rocker, power button position on the right side here. On the top, we have one of the speakers. All of them carry basically a stereo speaker. And of course, we have the IR blaster and one of the microphones positioned on the top. On the bottom, bottom firing speaker, USB-C, microphone, and a dual SIM tray positioned here. But there is NFC support. Now, all three devices are featuring a 6.67-inch display running at 100, basically refresh rate up to 120 frames per second. The storage and RAM configuration will vary between each one, going all the way from 8 gigs of RAM all the way to 12, as well as the ability of going all the way up to 512 gigs of internal storage. So depending on the version that you're looking at, you're seeing here that I do have the 512 gigs of storage in here. Now, here we're looking at Android 13 that's going to be powering this, and Android 13, but with MIUI 14, both on running the X6 and the M6 Pro. But when we switch over to obviously the X6 Pro, this one is running Android 14 with HyperOS out of Xiaomi. So this is definitely very nice. The upgraded experience will be available on the upper version, obviously. The processor that we're looking here on all three, the Dimensity 9300 Ultra, the 7S Gen 2 from Qualcomm, and here we have the Dimensity or the MediaTek Helio G99 Ultra, providing us a slightly different experience between all three. We're going to talk about them. What they're calling as far as the display that we have in here is a crystal res display. So it's a higher resolution than 1080p, 1.5K is what they're referring to it, and that'll give us the experience between all three devices. I did not enable gestures on all three, but you're able to see that they all support it. Fluidity is very, very nice, very good. We have access to an app drawer. I customized each one of them with the experience, and I'm running them all at 120 frames per second. You can definitely see the refresh rate is very good. I did install some games. We're going to talk about that in a little bit, but of course, let's go ahead and talk as far as the actual benchmarks. Now, what we talked about the experience here, budget, mid-range, upper mid-range, this is exactly how the benchmarks are giving us those answers. 1454 on the 83 Ultra, 1030 on the 7S Gen 2, and 729, obviously, on the Helio 99 Ultra. The experience is very nice. They're all very responsive. They all have all the customizations that you'd expect out of Android that comes in with MIUI 14 on both. Let's just go into here. I was looking at a picture of it. And of course, gaming is going to be reflective of that. We're going to talk a little bit about how Call of Duty actually plays on all three, as well as how PUBG Mobile gets that 90 frames per second mode built in directly to the X6 Pro. But if I had to kind of categorize them, is although they share the same optics, so the cameras on the back and the 60 megapixel camera on the front, they share them technically. The experience does actually change when you get into the camera experience, because when we jump into video, 4K 30 frames per second is going to be the maximum we get here on the X6 Pro. On the X6, it's very much similar experience, 4K 30, but you'll notice that essentially when we go into photo, let's go ahead and jump in here, we actually have slightly different experiences. It's been not really carrying the exact same sensors, or at least the exact same focal lengths from the sensor. Anything above one on all three of these devices are somewhat digital crop on the main sensor. Just be aware, your best images are going to be coming out straight in from that 1X. When we go into video, as I mentioned, 10K, 4K 30 on the maximum here, 4K 30, and of course, 10K, well, 1080p 60 available here to give us the best experience on them. And that's going to be coming up at a main 64 megapixel sensor on the back. All three have stereo speakers, and all three feature a very good customization level in the OS. So you can actually just go in, pinch in, and then you can customize the experience, jump in and customize all of the stuff. Again, this is running HyperOS, so there are some new optimizations done from HyperOS to customize the icon pack and so on. So let's go ahead and we'll just say okay. And one of the biggest things that we'll say is that they updated the weather app. Let's go ahead and launch the weather app here. This is what you're going to see, MIUI 14 style. And of course, obviously what we're getting here with HyperOS, you can get all the information down to here. Swipe down, you'll notice it's slightly different, but they all run very nice. No issue as far as running any social media apps or anything like that. You're not going to have any problems. The cameras experience that we talked about here, we're going to share actually the experience of the cameras, because I'm shooting part of this video before I go to Las Vegas for CES. I'm going to actually show you guys a lot of those images from CES, as well as some images I have here from LA. So what you're looking at right now is just overall specification. We have all three devices, volume level, all at 100%. And again, as I mentioned, all three carrying stereo speakers and the IR blaster. One last thing before we get into audio. Although the X6 Pro is considered to be the best spec version of it, both the X6 and the M6 are featuring basically a headphone jack on top of the other sensors that we have on the top, where the X6 does not have a headphone jack. That's one thing that's missing from the Pro version on the X6. So X6 and M6 Pro carry a headphone jack, dual SIM card, 4G LTE, 5G, 5G, but no headphone jack here. So the stereo speakers are going to be pretty much the only way, or using a USB-C pair of headphones. So, or obviously Bluetooth, since we'll be able to use that as well. We're going to start off here. We're playing Jumbo by NCS Release, our favorite song on the channel. This is going to be playing at 100% level volume, and we're going to play a sample from all three. So overall, audio on this is definitely going to sound good, although I will say that technically the X6 and the M6 Pro are going to feature somewhat of an additional option that I feel like is needed at this time, and that's the headphone jack that's present in here. So headphone jack on both, no headphone jack, but all three carrying some great audio. Between the speakers, I feel like the X6 and the X6 Pro did technically take it a little bit. On the M6, it didn't feel as bassy, but I will definitely say that they're all loud enough, and they should be more than enough to give us that experience for listening to audio, playing games, which has been really good on all three of these devices. Now, when it comes down to gaming, one thing I'll probably say here with Call of Duty Mobile, we definitely have the game turbo that gives us the ability of boosting the graphics for the frame rate, recording our screen, voice configuration, clearing memory, and getting the best experience. And that's present on across all three of these devices. 60 frames per second is going to be the best on the M6 Pro, 90 frames per second is going to be on the X6, and 120 frames per second present here on the X6 Pro. Again, the processor is going to be doing obviously the improvements over each generation. 8300 Dimensity Ultra is going to be giving us the best experience when it comes down to Call of Duty Mobile. PUBG Mobile as well, we do have a 90 frames per second smooth resolution setting built in. And what we're getting here essentially about roughly a 40 frames per second on both the M6, well, the X6 and the M6 Pro. But definitely the best gaming experience if you're looking for a brand new device, especially when it comes down to gaming on your portable device, this is going to be one of the best. 120 frames for Call of Duty, and of course 90 frames per second on PUBG Mobile. absolutely fantastic, and all three devices are definitely not going to disappoint with the stereo speakers that we have built in here. Again, headphone jacks on both the X6 and the M6 Pro. The X6 Pro is definitely going to be benefiting from a pair of headphones or a wired USB-C cable or the speakers that we have here. So we talked about gaming, and again, X6 Pro definitely going to take a win there, although I will say having a pair of headphones connected directly to your smartphone will give you that low latency personal experience that you can get only from using a pair of headphones. So the X6 and the M6 Pro definitely have a plus in that section, and I'm not sure why we're using, I probably will say, is a higher end version losing that feature that makes it so much easier. But across the board, great gaming devices, the X6 Pro definitely takes the win there. And let's start talking about cameras, and although we say they have similar sensors, or basically the same sensors on all three devices, the camera experience changes dramatically based on the processing that's going in the device, and of course that's no secret there. What we're getting here is an entry level to a mid-range and an upper mid-range experience that's going to span across the cameras that we see in here. We're going to start off with the X6 Pro, obviously the star of the show, and of course I'm going to show you guys some images here from LA as well as Vegas and some videos from there, and it's not going to disappoint. I'll say this much for all three of these devices across the board, the 64 megapixel camera on the back is going to be the star of the show. You're going to get your best images from there, you're going to get the best video from there, and when you start using some of the other sensors, you'll notice there's a little bit of different quality. The 4K resolution we talked about on the cameras on the back on both the X6 and the X6 Pro only work on the main 64 megapixel camera. They don't work on the 8 megapixel ultra wide or on the front facing 16. 1080p is going to be the resolution you can go there for video, but I will probably say again, stick to the 64 and you're not going to be disappointed. And of course, the experience there is very much clear. You're getting beautiful pictures, great processing, and of course, we're getting HyperOS to be able to give us some of those new improvements that Xiaomi's putting in with Android 14. And now switching it over to the X6 5G, again, very nice, very good processing experience there. Now, the 7S Gen 2 is an improvement over what we saw last year, and it still builds on that experience that Qualcomm's been putting in there to their devices as far as processing horsepower and GPU, and of course, capability of shooting 4K 30 frames per second on that main sensor, which will be mirrored to what we saw with the X6 Pro. Although we get the same resolutions, I still feel like the X6 Pro does have a little bit of an edge when it comes to processing, because it is technically a more powerful processing device, meaning much better processing, much more compression. If you're editing, if you're putting any kind of filter or anything like that, you're gonna definitely feel the difference in performance between the Pro and the non-Pro version of the X6. But images look great, again, shooting here in LA and in Vegas, and you can definitely enjoy all of those. I'm really impressed with what POCO is able to do with the price range and the devices that they're putting out. Now, last but not least, the entry level, or I probably will say is the upper entry level version here, which is the M6 Pro. Now, the Helio G99 Ultra is no slouch. One thing I will say though, we are capped at 1080p across all devices or all lenses that we have in here. But the main sensor on the back will still give you the best solution. Again, you're using the best hardware to provide you the best experience, and across the board, that's going to be that 64 megapixel camera. I'm not saying anything bad about the other ones, but I feel like that the best performance to make the device shine will have to be coming out from there. So if you're going to shoot video, if you're going to shoot pictures, focus on that 64, and I feel like you'll get the really good experience. But it is going to be obviously limited to what we can get that with the Helio G99 Ultra. But overall, again, as you see those images and videos I'm showing you guys right now, they definitely do not disappoint for the price point that this device is coming in. Obviously, you have to kind of set the expectations, and it definitely does hit it out of the park, where it's landing. Okay, so at the end of the day, we asked the question at the beginning of the video, which one of these devices is for you? I'll say that it's pretty much going to be structured on what you're looking for. If you're looking for a great gaming phone, I feel like the X6 Pro is going to definitely be knocking it out there. When it comes down to photography, I feel like the X6 and the X6 Pro kind of get close enough to each other when it comes to images and video, at least from the capabilities we're able to get from the 7S Gen 2 as well as the 8300 Ultra from the MediaTek. So I feel like both of those will definitely take those two approaches. When it comes down to fluidity and general day-to-day activity, social media, email, and of course processing and everything, I feel like all three of these devices are definitely going to perform very well. I feel like the little bit of an edge over on performance is the fact that the 7S Gen 2 on the X6 has an extra 100 milliampere in the battery, which allows it to actually last maybe a little bit longer. So I'll give the edge over to the X6 over the other two, but they definitely don't necessarily feel like they're any slouches. The batteries are very large in there, and they definitely have very nice support for 67 watt charging. Again, included in the box that is coming in there with the case. There's a screen protector on each one of them. So at the end of the day, what I'll say is that whichever device you end up picking not only will meet but will also exceed your expectations as long as you go into it with where the price point and the features that are coming with this device are coming to you. Hopefully we'll see Android 14 on both the X6 and the M6 Pro. They're coming out with Android 13 with MIUI 14, or maybe see them come over to HyperOS as well. I will say that having HyperOS on obviously the X6 Pro makes the experience even much better with some of those new optimizations that we get with Android 14. I love the fact that we definitely get kind of like a gamut of experience from entry all the way to upper mid-range with POCO. Like and subscribe as usual. Thank you very much for the support. I'll see you in the next video.